name is Jess, and this is another CRAS After Hours special. So today, we're going to be doing Beat Making 101. I know, how to make a beat, quick and easy, let's go. So, we got Logic Pro X open right here, and the first thing that we're going to do is start off with a completely blank session because we're going to make it simple. People get lost in the complexity of things, and we're just going to make it simple. So, first things first, software instrument. Logic has a lot of really good software instruments built in. This is a very basic installation of Logic too. I don't have any fancy instruments like I normally use in my personal stuff. So this is a good place to actually keep it simple, not get lost in the options, and actually come out with something on the other end. So software instrument. Now this is just the way that I happen to make a session. This is if I have no other idea and I just want to sit down and just make something, who cares how it comes out? Practice is practice and practice is good. So let's keep it super simple. I don't even need to see this library because I don't even want presets. Presets are too complicated. We're gonna take a look at our mix window, and you know what? I don't even want these reverbs because this is too complicated. We're gonna delete that. We're gonna delete that because we don't need it. We don't need these sends. We're gonna delete that. Freaking delete that guy. Look at that, super simple, super basic. Anyway. So here we have a classic electric piano. Now for me personally, unless I have something in mind, I'm actually going to start off with drums. I find that the drums are the structure of most of the stuff that I work on, and I don't know, I've always just liked playing around with rhythm. So over here we have our instruments. We don't have any effects, super simple. So what we need is a drum kit instead of a piano. So I'm gonna go with the Ultra Beat, which intimidates quite a lot of people. It does look like an alien spaceship. So it looks like we're actually controlling something flying to planet Xanadu, and it's very daunting. But really, if you think about it, it's super simple because we just have our keys to actually trigger the sounds right there. And those actually correspond as well with our musical typing keyboard, which we can use to audition things here. So we got musical typing, Command K for the quick key. That'll bring this up. And as long as we're in the right section of the keyboard, as far as how the octaves fall here, we're pretty close to actually playing exactly the instruments here. So, cool. All right. And so now I'm going to choose just a basic kit to get started with. And again, you can get lost in the complexity of this. Of course, everybody wants a good sound, but for right now, it doesn't really matter to me. So let's go with classic hip hop. Audition that. Cool. Let's go with that. Perfect. So we got our classic hip hop. There's all this other stuff. You know what we're going to do with that? Nothing. We're not going to do anything with that because we're keeping it simple. Not going to mess with the sequencer, not going to mess with this, because we're going to come back to that in a future tutorial, I promise. So, I'm going to close that. Super simple. This, I just wanted to use for auditioning. So, we're going to close that too, because we're actually going to write in our basic beat. And so, up here, I'm going to change our tools a little bit. So instead of the crosshair, I want a pencil tool because I'm going to create a new region. I'm also going to set that into loop mode just for those four bars. So that's all I want to listen to. That is the super most basic part of a beat that you can make. It's just four bars and a beat. So we have our region, and if we double click on this, it'll bring up our piano roll editor. So we just want to find the corresponding note using the pencil tool here is my preference, because we're going to be creating and selecting things mostly with the pencil tool. So we'll go through there. Oh. And there is the kick. That is a wonderful kick. I like it. Now, since we're in loop mode, we can just keep auditioning it. And we're going to need to add more than just one. So let's go with a basic 4-4 beat. So we have 4-4 right there. That's the most common time signature. That's what most songs that you're going to listen to are going to be in. We can change this if we wanted to, but we're not going to because we're keeping it simple. So now we have a 4-4 kick down here. Cool. Now, in contrast to what the kick is actually doing is we need a snare. So those two kind of go together. They accent each other. So kick, snare, that kind of thing. So let's find a good snare. Usually they're around, it's a tom. So yes. Perfect. So there's our snare. Just guess about like that. Not as many snare hits typically as a kick, but that depends on what you want it to sound like too. Pretty basic. We could also adjust our kicks to be a little off in timing to give it a different feel if we wanted. and adjust the snare to match it too. Nice. As well, I mean, really, if you wanted to think about the most common heard things in a drum kit, the hi-hat is going to be the most common thing that you're going to hear altogether. So we're going to find a good hi-hat. There's a good closed hat, so that's going to be our most percussive. That's really going to carry the time for us, so you're going to find a lot more of those guys in there than really anything else. We can throw maybe an open hat in there to contrast it a little bit. Yeah, now we're getting a little complicated. That'll work. Now, we can play around and just listen to whatever else we have here and see if something sparks your fancy. That's a pretty cool sound. And sometimes that's what I go by. Just play around until you find a cool sound and then see where it fits. And sometimes just playing it one time is cool like that. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I dig it. All right, nice. So I actually kind of like that drum beat, and so we're going to bring this down a little bit. And if we double click in this empty space, we can create another instrument. So we got our drums down. Next thing we need is a melody. And so we're going to go back here. What don't we need? We don't need these buses because we're keeping it simple. So piano is one thing, but out of all these options, a lot of these are complicated, but I like the retro synth because it's very straightforward. So we're going to pick this guy. And again, bring up the musical typing so we can actually audition the sounds that we have. So by default, we can change the octave. Not bad. We can change the sounds by going through here as well. And so we can do bass lines, we can do pads, which are kind of more like swelling, kind of floaty kind of instruments. But leads are really what are going to give us a little bit more bite and kind of more response if we want to actually make a sequence, really. So out of these, I don't know, find one that's interesting. I like 50s sci-fi. Interesting. And let's see. All right. Not too shabby. We change the octave. Kind of creepy. That's cool. I can actually dig that. Perfect. All right. So we don't need to mess with any of this. Of course we could, but we'll get back to that later once we have a basic beat down. Basic beat down. Right. So here we can actually record. Let's say we got something that we liked. Bring up that again. And we can not only audition things, but we can also record things using the musical typing keyboard. So making sure that we're record enabled there. That's what is actually going to allow us to record to this particular track. And then we're going to press the record button and it's going to give us a countdown. So we actually gonna have what's called pre-roll. Pre-roll leads us up to the beginning of the beat so we can actually get ready. So we're not behind and actually keep up with everything. So check it out. Here we go. Okay, so I got the idea in there. I got the notes in there that I wanted. So that's the hard part. Now if we double click on this again, we can see that the notes have fallen right there. And so it's a very on... not what I like. So let's bring this guy back a little bit and stretch this one out a little bit longer. This is the beauty of MIDI programming right there, is because we can adjust the sounds after the fact. And bring this guy out a little bit longer and make this guy wait just a smidge. Maybe a little bit more. Right on. And so there you go. So there we have the drums, and we got a melody, and to fill up the bottom end, we want a bass line indeed, so get rid of this, get rid of that, super simple, and go for a bass line. Now, really, the only difference between like a lead and a bass is really the octave that is played in a lot of times, so if we go back here and bring up the same synth and just change the octave pretty low, that could work as a bass line too. Let's get something a little fresh. So we got bass, and then out of these options here, hollowed bass sounds interesting. Let's see what that's all about. Cool. for me. We can play with these, but we're not going to. So here we go. And we can do the same thing to record this. I mean, we could even copy and paste this region if we wanted to, and that would keep it even simpler. But I'm going to go ahead and freehand in another bass line. All right. So that wasn't too bad. Let's take a look at how these notes actually fell as well. They're pretty close to the same. So I want the bass to hit with the kick. Usually the bass and the kick work together pretty well. That's covering up our neat little sound up there. So let's bring that back a little bit more. Let's blend these together. So now you have a kick, you have a harmony, and you got a bass line. And from there on, you can pretty much create anything that you wanted, even just accented sounds too. So we can go through and, I mean, if we wanted to pick from any kinds of other models, there's all kinds of other stuff that we have in here. And we could even add something as simple as another synth. Just start stacking synths to give a unique sound. So strings, let's maybe just eerie strings to throw it in the background there. Maybe play something in time with that. I bet that would be a pretty cool sound right there, too. All right, so let's see. See, this is another thing you got to be aware of with the pre-roll is sometimes it may fall before and you're not going to hear it because with our loop point set like that, it's actually never going to play that note. So we want to drag that note into a section it's actually going to be played in. And since this is kind of more of a breathing pad kind of thing, you want to let it actually play for a while. It has to have that note on message for a minute so we can actually hear it develop. And then from there, super simple, we can just drag things out like this. If you hold the Option key while you click and drag a selection, then we can actually make exact duplicates. And then from there, we can even mute some of these by selecting them and pressing M. That'll mute these tracks, or we can mute just the individual regions too, or just delete them completely. And that'll give us some more space so we can actually build into a song too. And there you have basically how to make a beat from scratch 101. So from there, it just depends on how complicated that you want to get. I mean, we haven't even begun to talk about adding different sounds or effects or signal routing or even having signals interact with each other too, like you can with gating and sidechaining and all that kind of stuff. So there's all kinds of options, but look, we just spent a couple minutes right there and we figured out, you know, from scratch to an actual something that we can work with. So I hope you enjoyed watching this and maybe this will give you some creative inspiration to move out from there. So. Right on. Have a good night, and we'll catch you later.